Hello students, Success Series is back with another video and today we will discuss Chapter 6 Tissues of CBSC NCERT Class 9. So let's begin. What are tissues? Tissues are a group of cells that are similar in structure and they work together to achieve a particular function. Simple organisms are made of only one type of cell that performs all the functions. On the other hand, complex organisms have different cells performing different functions. Now let's see the classification of tissues. Tissues are broadly classified into plant tissues and animal tissues. In this video, we will discuss plant tissues in detail. Plant tissues are classified into meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. Permanent tissue is further classified into simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue. We will discuss them in detail. Meristematic tissue. This tissue is found in most plants and it is responsible for the growth of plant. Cells in these tissues can divide and form new tissues. It is of three types: apical meristem, which is present at the tip of stem and root and responsible for the growth in length; lateral meristem, which is present beneath the bark and responsible for the growth in girth of trunk; lastly, intercalary meristem, which is present in nodes of leaves and cells. Permanent tissues. Permanent tissues are basically differentiated meristem cells which have changed their shape and size to get specialized and perform different functions inside the plant body. It is of two types: simple tissues, which are made of same type of cell, and the complex tissues, which are formed of different cells performing one function. Simple tissues, composed of structurally and functionally similar cells. It is of four types. Parenchyma has cells which are live and they are oval, elongated and loosely packed with large intracellular spaces. These tissues are found throughout the plant body. Colenchyma. Cells of colenchymas are live. They are also oval, elongated and tightly packed with no intracellular spaces. It provides mechanical support. Sclerenchyma, cells are dead. They are narrow and elongated. These are found near vascular bundles, veins of leaves, etc. Epidermis covers entire body of plant and similar in structure as parenchyma. They protect plant from injury and germs and sometimes water loss. Lastly, cork, simple tissue which consists of dead cells with no intracellular spaces. They form the outer layer of old trees. Now let's see complex tissues. Complex tissues are of two types: xylem and phloem. Now one by one we will look into each. First is the xylem. Xylem is responsible for the transportation of water and nutrients from the root to the upper part of the plant. It is composed of four types of cells. First is the vessel, which is the pipe-like structure. Vessels are basically dead and have lignified thick cell wall. Tracheids are long elongated cells with tapered ending. Cells are dead and these transports water through pits. Next is parenchymas. These are living cells. They store food and nutrients. Lastly, sclerenchymas are dead cells and they provide the mechanical support to the plant. Now, phloem tissue transports food from site of photosynthesis to different parts of the plant. It is also composed of four types of cells. Sieve cells, which are elongated and have thin cell wall. These cells are responsible for transportation of food and nutrients. Then companion cells have cytoplasm, nucleus and other cell organelles. They perform the task which is required for sieve cells for living. Then phloem parenchyma, it stores food. And lastly, phloem fibers have thick cell wall and provide mechanical support to the plant body. Now, differences between xylem and phloem based on certain parameters. The cells are dead in xylem but living in phloem. Cell wall thickness, thick in xylem and thin in phloem. Material, lignin is the material in xylem and in phloem it is absent. Permeability, Xylem is highly impermeable, but phloem is permeable. Cytoplasm, there is no cytoplasm in xylem, but cytoplasm is present inside the phloem. Function of xylem carries water and salts. Phloem carries sugar and nutrients. Now, direction of flow is upwards in the case of xylem, and in the case of phloem, it is down and up both. Lastly, we will see the differences between meristematic and permanent tissues. Meristematic tissues are continuously dividing cells. Permanent tissues do not divide continuously. Cells are small in meristematic tissue. In permanent tissue, they are variable in shape and size. The cell wall is thin in meristematic tissue and thick in permanent tissue. Nuclei are very large in meristematic tissue compared to the permanent tissue. Vacuoles are absent in meristematic and present in permanent tissue. Cells are undifferentiated in meristematic and differentiated in permanent tissue. That's all in this chapter. Do not forget to see the part 2, animal tissues. And for more such videos, do subscribe to our channel, Success Seeds Education. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.